Hi, it's Jan Caney at My Local Business Online, and today I'm going to show you all about Pinterest map pins and how to add a business to Foursquare when you don't own the business and they're not already in the Foursquare database. Now, as you can notice, I pinned some blog posts from local businesses onto my board of local business bloggers, which if you want to join that board and you're a local business blogger, just drop me an email or contact me via the comments below and I'll add you. Anyway, as you can see, if you want to map a pin, you click on map the pin, choose your city, and this is in Widnes, and this is from Phoenix Counselling. And what Pinterest will then do is search Foursquare because the map is powered by Foursquare. Unfortunately, Phoenix isn't listed on Foursquare, so we can't map their pin. Now, if you're the actual business owner, you don't want to use this method I'm going to show you now. What you want to do is pop over to business.foursquare.com/listing, hit the Get Started button and add your business to Foursquare, and that way you can have people checking in and offer prizes for being there and all sorts of other wonderful things. Works best of all for entertainment type establishments, whether you're a pub or a restaurant or a cinema, bowling alley, whatever. So do it that way. So it's business.foursquare.com/listing. That's if you own the business and it's somewhere that people can walk into. You have a physical premises that people can visit. Now, what if you don't own the business and the information is not on Foursquare and therefore you can't pin your pins as a map place pin on Pinterest? Well, first of all, you need to have a Foursquare account. So log into your Foursquare account and then go to foursquare.com/add_venue, and you get this lovely page where you can add all the details. And obviously, if you have the Foursquare app, you can get the app and do all this on your mobile phone. And since I do not do mobile phones and I do not do checking in anywhere on any site, that's a bit useless for me. So here we go. So we're going to add the details on here so that we can start pinning the blog post onto the Pinterest map board. Now, it is important to use the business name as it is shown on the storefront. So now you get the little map and you drop the pin where you want the map to go. And it's on Albert Road between Greenway and Park Road. And you can add the Twitter handle and phone number as well. And their professional and other places. Once you've added all the details and clicked the map where you want the pin to drop, just click Save. Okay, once you've clicked save, that's the information inputted into the database, which you can share. Obviously, if it's your business, you can claim it now to make sure that all of the information is up to date. And if you really want to leave a tip as well, you can leave a tip. Now, once you've added all the information and you've reached this page, it's just a case then of waiting for the database to update itself, and then you can start mapping your pins. So it's been a couple of hours since I added Phoenix Counselling's information to Foursquare, and now I've come back to Pinterest now to add the Pinterest map pin to a couple of the blog posts that I pinned quite a while back now. We're just going to see if it's here. So we're going to map the pin. Again, choose a city. And then start typing in the business name. There it is. And then click map it. And as you can see, it's mapped from Foursquare and it's now on the map. So I can continue doing this for all the Phoenix Counselling pins. I won't bore you with it all. And it really is that simple. So enjoy creating your Pinterest map pins, and don't forget to add the business to Foursquare so that you have this wonderful bit of functionality to your Pinterest map boards. I'll speak to you soon.